seals to see, it will stay.
This is an open letter for the attention of the prison warden in you. Its words spilling out through brown paper, foaming at the mouth,
say,
dissolving. This letter won't burn. It is to be wet, to touch, to envelop and immerse like no other scripture. It will stick.
Say!
Watermarked and salivating, sealing and resealing, opening to let you in and closing to hold you close. All this writing I send you will spit.
Say!
Until this warden can tell what words feel like. Discard this correspondence in untouched in trays, behind grates, hidden by windowless structures. If it's too real to touch, it will breathe light. This fecund scribbling will drip infinity puddles. It will not allow you to read between lines. There are none. Unfocused bluff colors, you will understand them when you remember that the world relies upon you for nothing but your smallest philosophy. And the twang in your voice, it has runnings of its own. Things grow, change, shudder, and fade away. Like this writing I sent you, you needn't open it. It will do so itself, like the eruption of childbirth. And it will read to the prison warden in you, who paces steps that sound out nervous in my ears. Steps that echo through your prison cells. There are more than one, and what they hold are whispers of fear. Shadows puppeted against time-chipped walls, but you were never clear enough of mind to see the strings. Strings that shift shape and pitch like a Lucy skydiving diamond memory. To the prison warden in you, who now scrapes fingernails against rust on shutter doors more fragile than he. To he, who can only see half lengths of the distances he needs to, so that each room falls blind at the point you thought you locked fear in dead stairs. I can smell that the infirmary sends you the rotten resurrection, more evocative than the opening of bakery air vents at dawn. I can see the jet stream Led Zeppelins leave when they blaze blasphemies across Kahului skies. I can imagine life-induced hallucination, but this letter was written to help you see the wood and believe it bore no teeth and know there's nothing wrong with screaming. The prison warden in you, old man, you are not just that, and needn't even be so at all. You have tried for too long to keep things under lock that have the power to choose when to come and go. You have reached through bars and mistaken what fingertips kiss for catharsis. I know what anxiety feels like when nervosa grips hold of lips and pumps the nail and dagger of pins and needles through organs and veins until you dry heave because you forget how easy it is to breathe. With sincerity, faith, and the most colloquial of footnotes, know this, this letter is yours. To soak your hands in when you lose touch, to turn tears blue when your visions blur, to bring the bursting neon Bible of graffiti to these chambers and hallways, to recite in your brightest of hours, and to take to the grave when you go. But no sooner, so that when rain clouds bloom, brimming with ink and saliva, the world will feel the damp of this embrace. Stained, the babble of calm will rise with the ferocity of the white water break of psychosis. And you can be these words, our violent messenger. Eat this homework, pen-based and soaked through, to fall at the feet of pterodactyls and flying ants, so that they can see, feel, and believe what gravity actually feels like when it pulls.
Life speaks to you.